it's tough to make it in the cattle business. You really need to like to do it. You have to have a passion for it. Otherwise, why do it?
The piece of window sitting way up high. I can't look up enough to see the sky.
Friends of mine now is 76 or 76.
I guess what really got it started was I wasn't utilizing the property. I wasn't ready to build fence and invest in cattle. My uncle kind of convinced me to do so. We fenced off some of the property.
I already told Jesus everything I know.
He had some younger cattle that he wanted to wean from the other cattle. He offered to bring them in. I brought them in and I enjoyed it. I asked him if I could purchase some of those from him, which got me started.
Last request.
I told my wife, I said, I just want to kind of get a feel for it, you know, get a few of them and see what it's like. Today we're up to 30 head of cattle. Either you like doing the cattle business or you don't. Once you get a taste of it, I think you find you might like it. At least twice a year, you have to vaccinate all your cattle for worms, for different diseases. All your calves, you have to dehorn them and prepare them to go to auction. When I got started in the cattle business, I was helping other people and I saw how they move cattle around with buggies, bikes, horses. The cattle were in a lot of stress. Through a master cattleman class that I took, I found out that it's best not to put the cattle in that type of stress. Now that we pin up, I use feed to get them into the place where we do all the vaccinations instead of pushing them. A lot of work involved. Tough for one man or a few people to do. Today is what we did. We all came together as a group. Got it done. Gets a little easier, but I'm always concerned that somebody gets hurt. So I often get in the pen.
Yo.
I don't want to get hurt, but I'd rather myself get hurt than one of my friends.
Yo.
He's only right there at the gate.
Close it.
Don't push him. Don't push them. Let's get these cows out of the way.
T-Bone is a registered F1 Brangus bull. He has a temperament.
Get in there, T-Bone.
He's coming, John.
But we was able to get him pinned up safely, no one got hurt. after a hard day's work, we're gonna go to the rodeo tonight. It's the Foosh Roping Club Rodeo, which is a club that I was a member of, and looking forward to getting back in with them. It's a local event, not a big rodeo, but something we really enjoy doing.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Foosh Parish Roping Club Rodeo. Tonight we bring in some of those youths from the Foosh Parish Roping Club from the great state of Louisiana.
Thing is all your friends coming together, your family coming together, and the pinups, the vaccinations, the cattle, but coming together. At any time I can call any of those guys that came today, and they'll stop what they're doing to come give me a hand. Same with my father, my son. I'm at work. No, I can't make it here on time to feed the cattle or give them water, and I come back and it's all done. So that's rewarding right there.
That's all the stuff I had, but if there's anything else you want to add, now's the time.
Yeah, just one more thing.
Okay.
I think this was more of a dream for me than the rest of my family, and they've been very supportive. My mom and dad, my wife, my kids, and throughout my whole life they've been supportive of any ideas that I've had, and they've backed me through this one, and I'm so glad they did, because we're all enjoying it.